Now, I know that I'm going to have to use this for the front part of this, but I'm going to put this down shortly, and we're going to get on our feet because this is an interactive workshop. Let me tell you a little bit about the history of this workshop. Okay.
Yes.
About 3 years ago, I had the... I'm going to start again. I like that. Over the years of clown care, we have from time to time in America, in our company, we've given workshops for medical staff. It was usually in response to them wanting it. About 3 years ago, I devoted some clear attention in collaboration with a chief of nursing staff at NYU College of Nursing. And we created a workshop together with the College of Nursing that took the communication skills of a professional performer and put them into a workshop for healthcare professionals. Now, I know I am from a different culture. I know that. Believe me, I know that. When I see the kind of partnership and the deep integration that you have here in the hospitals with the medical staff, I am in awe. Truly, and I'm inspired by this. We do not have this depth of relationship in the States, and there is a much clearer hierarchy. So what you're going to be doing, I know it looks like I'm the one here who's be leading this. For the next hour and not quite hour and a half, hour and 20 minutes, we're going to be in a collaborative relationship. Exercise is going to be determined by both of us in a collaborative spirit. This is an hour and a half version of a two-hour workshop. For the last 3 years, I have given this workshop in its two-hour form because when you're in a hospital, we can't expect that we're going to get healthcare professionals for more than 2 hours. 2 hours is a really long time. Usually, it's an hour. So we have a two-hour version, the hour and a half version that you are going to experience today, and an hour version that is usually about a 50-minute version for some doctors and things who are going to come here, you know, for an hour and give you an hour of their time. Very briefly, our job descriptions, the clown and the doctors, are different, but the communication skills that are necessary to fulfill the job description are very much the same. And that's what we're going to be investigating today. And it's much simpler than you think. What these 2 hours are actually going to, these 2 hours or hour and a half is actually the first day of the workshop that I give for professional artists, for clowns, because they have to do with the simple act of being present, not being attached to there or there, to making genuine, direct contact, and to being in that state that we heard described today earlier of unknowing. I tell people, start to get comfortable with not knowing. And we're going to be standing in front of the doorway today, both physically and virtually, because we all stand, particularly in our professions, we stand between many, many doorways outside. And that's a critical moment. A lot happens in that. And what we're going to be playing with, and it really is play, are communication skills. Okay, I think that's enough of the overview. Oh, you don't have to take notes. You don't have to take notes. I've already taken them for you. And you don't have to worry about passing this class. You have already received A's. In fact, yes, give yourself a round of applause. That would be fine. I'm not going to teach you anything. If anything, I'm going to remind you of some certain things that either you've forgotten or particularly, I'm going to start treating you like medical professionals as if you are not performers, you are simply people in the healthcare industry with no performing experience whatsoever. So I'm not teaching you anything. I may be reminding you of things you may have forgotten. And believe me, I know what you do. I know the list of things that I've worked beside you for the last 25 years, and I know what you do, and I am in awe of what you do. So enough of the talk. This is not an intellectual experience. This is one. Most of the notes are going to be in your bodies, in your breath, in your spirit. So let's get started. So empty your hands. Put your hands, nothing in your hands. Stand up, please. Feet have to move back and give us more space. We don't want you to think. Here we go. Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. certain consistency over in this area. Fourth word, march closely. Now, in different settings, different organizations, and different groups of people use different words. I use the relatively universal, straightforward one, and here's the gesture. Start with your hands up here, and then you go like this, and then you go like this, and here is anyone, when they get voice, quote, zap, whatever, they can go, freak out! And you go, and you cannot be in the same place at the end of this that you have to find another place in the circle. You fill this space. It's okay if you tromp the chicken, it doesn't matter. All right? But I want you to commit to it. It's freak out. It's total mayhem. They will hear us. It's okay. And then find yourself another place on the circle. It'll settle down. And the one who called the freak out will then whoosh or zap. All clear? Let's have it.
Wow.
Huh? Everybody! Okay? I don't think it's too difficult. Let's try it. Yeah. Freak out! Consideration. You don't have to play 10 minutes of a silly game to be in this state. You can simply take a breath and choose to be right here. Right here, just like this. And then I pose another question to you. If you're in this state, you're open and everything, what do you think patient and your colleagues' feelings are going to be about you? I'm just putting that out for your consideration. So now that we feel really good, we're going to go to a couple of very clear, simple observational exercises. When you stand in front of that doorway, anyone stands in front of the doorway, you want to know, you want to make yourself receptive to physical information and emotional information. So we're going to do a couple of games here. Let's divide up into twos, pairs, your pairs, your pairs, pairs. Your pairs come into the middle. Who pairs? Your pair. What's your name?
Margarita.
Can I call you Maggie?
No.
Margarita. All right. Here's the exercise. It's called camera. Margarita is the camera. Her eyes are closed. I'm the camera operator. I'm going to maneuver my camera around the room. I'm going to adjust the lens. I'm going to take a picture Margarita will know that because I'm going to push her back. I'm going to push into my thumbs into her back real quickly, like I'm clicking a camera. I'm going to go click, click, which point she opens her eyes and closes her eyes very quickly. She's just taking a snapshot. Now I readjust the camera, move the camera over here. I'm going to take another photo. Click, click. take three photos only, and then I'm going to stand in front of my camera, and I'm going to download the images. Margarita's going to tell me simply what she saw in the frame. What did you see?
Light.
So light and her. Very simple exercise. There's no need to talk in this exercise. There'll be plenty of talking exercises as we move along through the workshop. So one of you be the camera, the other one, camera operator, and take three snapshots, please, then download them. Okay? And don't switch. Do it one time and don't switch, please. People who don't know where they're going. People who are headed where they don't know. Now you know what it feels like. Now, what I would like, you are going to switch, but what I would like the partner to do now is, knowing this, and it's kind of a stressful thing, knowing this, employ whatever techniques you feel are appropriate to make your camera feel comfortable. You understand? Whatever appropriate method you might invent to make this less stressful for your camera in moving them into the unknown. Okay? Off you go. You can talk. Off you go.
Change partners.
It's all going to be okay. Don't worry. Okay, sorry.
Yeah.
All right.
And I'm going to turn to your right, and we're going to go straight about 10 steps. One,
someone like to share one of the methods they use to make their camera a little more comfortable, please?
Yes. There was a moment that he walked with me like this, and then he walked with me like this. So I felt like this, I can go.
We kind of cradled you.
Yes.
That's nice.
Yeah,
it's very nice.
The same, but with this. I'm talking.
Yes. Talking?
Yeah.
Nice.
I said take 10 steps forward.
And I can't.
Yes, and we're going to move to the left.
Telling them exactly what's going to happen.
Yes.
Yeah. Carrying voice.
Mm-hmm. Carrying voice. Guiding them.
He prepared me that I'm going to see a beautiful
friend. Fantasy! Okay, we're going to move on. Good. So you get the point. Imagine you're a healthcare professional. We're going to do another simple exercise and observation. Keep your same partners, and I'll walk through the exercise with you. With what's your first name?
Joyce.
Joyce. Here's the exercise. I want you to stand in front of your partner, and I'm going to vocalize it. You won't be vocalizing it, but in order for you to understand the exercise, I'll vocalize it. I'm looking at Joyce. I see the glasses. I'm noticing the way her hair is, and the little fluffs here, the two earrings, the necklace. Okay, nothing, okay, the rings over here, rings over here, rings over there. The pant legs are kind of up calf level, and I'm noticing the shoes. Now I'm going to turn around, and Joyce is going to make three changes. Because I've played the game before, I'm going to see where you might be looking that might tip me off to some changes that she's making. Okay, good, you're not looking.
Kenny Raskin exercise.
Yeah, he got it from Michael.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, there is a religion person in the hospital.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
In Jerusalem.
Okay, this is up here. One earring is off. Glasses. Off you go. Try it one time around with one individual, then we'll stop. Where's your partner?
Tell me when you're ready. Ready.
Maybe we continue here.
Purple here, too. And green here. And green here. The shirt up is inside.
Okay. I'm here. Nose is on.
Just one partner does it.
One tie. Yes.
Yeah, don't take a picture of me.
Fairly obvious. And then depending on you, the choices and the comfort that we have, you'll be making the choices of how to change the room. Rest assured, no one is going to do this. So here's the game. The person stands here, you take in the room. You leave. We will make three changes in the room. Come back in and take a nice breath right here. You'll say, the screen was off. That's different. The lights are different. And the shades back there were open. Say thank you. That's it. Let's just play the game. Hi. Okay, who wants to go? Okay, Margarita. Margarita's up first. Just one person.
Oh, okay.
Margarita. Just relax. Take in the room. It's a little deceptive, because what I'm really interested here is Margarita's state of mind. This is a great state of mind. She's taking in real information, there's presence, there's no bullshit. Okay, see you in a minute. Fantastic right now.
Yes.
He always has a good mind.
You're present. And I would go further. Look at her. A delightful young woman. Hey, so you're a healthcare individual. So now, because it happened early on in the workshop, I will put this forward to you. Can you imagine simply being present with the patient before you reach for any of those millions of things that you have to do? Can you imagine simply, and how long does it take? How long does it take? It takes a breath to stand here and let Margarita manifest for a moment. And how do you think the patient's going to feel? No, they're not going to say, my Margarita, I feel you're lovely, I feel more secure. They will feel this, and it's going to make every single thing that you have to do that much easier. The person's going to feel great. And what have you done? You've done nothing but simply be present. What's the third change?
No idea.
No idea. Wow, and I thought that was going to be the easiest.
Yeah.
Someone else do it. Yes. What's your name, please?
Jack.
Jack. Okay, Jack. Show me. Do it. Okay. What's important is not that it gets them, it's a state of mind. And in the beginning, we're kind of laughing and chuckling because you have a natural sense, you have a natural fun sense about it. Before you do anything, before you put the nose, before you do anything, you have a natural sense of it. It's a nose. So what are the other three things?
One.
Okay, we're gonna level with you now. That's all one. Because
oh, no, I see.
Half that.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. That's only one. And you got me.
Yeah, yeah.
So you have two more, Char.
Two more.
Yeah, and a bonus.
Thank you.
Okay, Mickey.
It's okay. Thank you.
Take a breath. State of mind, so he is right now. Okay, good state of mind.
Seven.
Thank you. Now you got the idea. We're just going to move along with it. We don't need to do that like that again. So here's a variation. In the States, we have a game called Where's Waldo? Little Waldo is this funny little character. And you open a page, and there's 100,000 people on the beach, and where's Waldo? So with a group this large, this is a fun variation. So we're going to set the main... Hi, come on in. Glad you're here. So we're going to set the predominant feeling in the room. Let's say sadness. Except for Tiffany, who's going to be quite happy. So, in this case, it's not where's Waldo, it's where's Wilma. So here's the game. Come in, take a breath. You're in the doorway. And I say, what's the feeling in the room? What's the dominant feeling in the room? And I'll say, attack. Is that it? That's what the other word is. Attack. Except for Tiffany. Happy. It's a challenge, but this, you know, it goes a little bit from simple to, oh, okay, who wants to go? Okay, what's your name? Joyce? Is it Joyce?
Yes.
See you in a minute. You know what we'll do, because it is a large number of people, and I don't want to make it that challenging right off, because we have some variations left. Let's have like two or three people in the room feel that differently. So what's the dominant feeling in the room?
Happy. So for you three people, you are four.
This little group here. Okay. Come on in, Joyce. Take a nice breath, Joyce.
They're all pretty joyful and light, except for Mr. the Yellow Shirt is like pretty withdrawn and grumpy.
Yeah,
him? Oh. and the three of them together.
Yeah.
It's nailed.
Those three?
Yeah.
This is state of mind. It's a good state of mind here. You understand the game?
Well, she's sad and he's...
She's done. She's accomplished this, but what's more important is the state of mind. And if you're a healthcare individual and working in healthcare, doctor, or whatever it is, this is a valuable state of mind to have, okay? Let's make a clinic. Let's put chairs, weights for a little clinic. You'll make it the way you want to. Just have some chairs, straight line, straight row, whatever clinic you would like to create, okay? Settle that, settle in, gentlemen, to the clinic, please. Nice clinic. at least once, perhaps more people who are in need, in any way that you want to create, in need. But you are really in need in some way in this clinic. Desperate need. Okay? And so here's the exercise. They come, they go out, they come back in. They take a breath. I'll make it very simple. The room feels happy. For Hans, who's sad, and she's sad, she's in need, she's in good need, along with her. That's the exercise. Now, this has 100% of applicability to healthcare people, particularly in a hospital. And even if you don't get it, you don't, if you misidentify, the state of mind that's necessary here is really a good one. Who wants to go? Okay. See you in a minute. Do not entertain us. Do not entertain us. What's the dominant feeling? How does that translate into feeling? You know, I think what the, that kind of that feeling boils down to anxiety, doesn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
No,
it's anxious.
Nervous.
Huh? That's all right. Let's make it real simple here so that we can move on.
Hot.
Okay. Loaded up fine. Okay, I like it. Here we go. Yeah, come on in. Probably the dominant feeling isn't too far, too hot, too. What's the dominant feeling in your hot, yes, hot. Who's not hot? Front row's not hot. Yeah, everyone's in the game. Where are the people who are in need? This is important for you to identify. It's a little tricky because some people are hotter than others. Didn't think about that.
Just about.
She's hot.
Over there?
That's right.
Yeah, she needs. say David Goffman, right?
Yeah.
And I'm not surprised with David. I always spent the day with David in Hadassah yesterday. You're a fantastic artist, and you make some of the quickest reads of people that I've ever seen. Really, you read situations very quickly. Good state of mind. We're going to leave this. We're going to go to another game. Now, I'm sure that at one point, it's a child's game. It's a child's game. Great. It's called hot and cold. I'm thinking of something in the room. I'm thinking of that water pitcher on the tray. As I move towards it, I'm getting warmer. Getting warmer, warmer, warmer. Pulling off. Freezing, warmer, warmer, burning up, that's the children's game. So we're going to play the game, but instead of using warm, hot, and cold, we're going to use applause. Being performers, I'm sure you like applause. Anybody likes it. Being a room full of healthcare professionals like it too. So here's the game, very simply. So I'm going to leave. We decide where we would like that person to go, to be, to do. We're going to start off really simple. Simple game. Let's say we would like the person to come in and go over to that chair and sit down. So we're going to start with a nice round of applause. We'll say, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ralph. We give Ralph a nice round of applause. Standing in front of the doorway. Take that breath, and you do what we call the first proposal. You're going to make a proposal. First proposal. And if that proposal is in the right direction, we're going to encourage you. What's your name?
Itai.
Okay, Itai. Itai.
Itai.
I'm going to call him Ralph.
That's good.
Okay. Where do you want Itai to go? Show me. Let's do it. Okay, you got it?
Yes.
I'm going to move my computer. Okay, we got it. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Itai. David.
Do it, David. Just do it.
No.
Come here, David, and go from here so we know. Oh, you better go somewhere else. Just do it. Go. Here's where we're going. Watch closely. I'm going here, going here, going here, here I am, here I am,
Thank you.
Oh, they want me to pick up the cord. I'm going to pick up the cord.
Yes.
And he got ready. I mean, all these moves here were not informed by us. He had the cord in his hand before he realized that wasn't the right choice. Lots of stuff in your head. Yes, you made it. But it's so clear this exercise when you leave us and you're in your mind. Someone else. This is great. I love this. What's your name?
Alex.
See you in a minute, Alex.
Yes.
You're just getting warmed up. Yeah, absolutely. All right, Alex.
Behind the curtain.
Show me. Stand up and do it, please. She's going to do it. Watch her. All right, here. Watch her. Right there. No, not that.
No, yeah.
Watch her. See where she went? Okay. That's child's play.
Go back.
We can do this like that.
Yeah.
This is not a problem. Everybody see it? I'll do the route just so we're sure we got on the same page. Here we are. Here. Look at the two people we're going. Here. And then back here. Please welcome Alex! Please welcome Kathy! technique that we're utilizing here. You're standing in front of the door. Any number of doorways that you can imagine as a performer. And there's a very special time when you're professionals, and it's a skill. And after a while, it can happen very quickly. You take in a tremendous amount of information very quickly in this state, physical and emotional. It comes in, it mixes with experience and instinct and outcomes and initial proposal. And you listen, you wait, because you got to get something back. If you don't get anything back, you have to make another proposal. And that something back might be someone's body. It might be a shift in the feeling of the room that you can't identify. It might be a sparkle in their eye. But you've got to make a proposal, and you've got to wait for something to come back. And that informs your next moment. I think it's what's called being alive. And for a healthcare professional to be in a room and to be informed by what's in the room, not what's in their mind, what they think is from the last book, blah, 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 blah. Let's do this again and let's really get, okay, let's get it involved. We only got 10 more minutes. Let's get one really going. You can do this. We have a great vocabulary and there's a great feeling in the room. All right, who goes? We won't make on video. Okay? We have 10 minutes, right?
Yes.
Yep.
Yep.
Yep. Yep. Let's do this game. Show me. Thing is, he's blind back there. We can't see him. Okay? All right, here. Okay, we'll do this because I can feel it start to deteriorate here. Right up there, here, here. One more good game, real focus. Here it is. Oh, we can't see him when he disappears. Here we are, right here. Starts right here. See where I am? Our enthusiasm got the better of us. And you know what? We're going to do it again. Not this one, but we're going to do another one. We're going to ask really good focus, a really good clean signal, and let's do a really good one. We were sloppy. It's fun, yes it is, but I think we can get a real tight fit. Okay, who's going?
Tito.
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 Tito?
Tito.
Tito. See you in a minute, Tito.
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 Tito. Tito. Thank you. Tito. Okay. Go ahead, show us. Okay. Everybody see it?
No, we have to stand up.
Have to stand up. You have to stand up. You have to stand up.
Okay.
Okay.
Maybe somewhere else.
Yeah, right there. Everybody clear?
So yes, because it will be, it must be very precise.
Actually, that's right.
If you do
must
like
be very
this.
Precise, and we must be very precise. All right, good concentration. No missed signals. Please welcome Tito. Out of your head. Thank you so much. This was fun.